Let's start off by including the necessary libraries. Standard Library and UniStd. If you're using Windows operating system, this will be Windows.h. Now let's declare the variables that we'll be using. Short minutes and seconds. Then for the whole thing, we're gonna use an integer called time. Now we take the input from the user but in a do while loop. Because we don't want the user to mess up the algorithm. We'll say that you gotta keep entering the amount of seconds unless you entered the right amount. Let's do the same for minutes. Now we'll check if the minutes entered by the user were not equal to zero. Because they wanted to run just for a few seconds. But in case they weren't, we'll convert the minutes into seconds by multiplying by 60 or else, they'll be zero. You could just write minutes, the name of the variable that stores minutes or just a constant value like this. Then we add the entered seconds to that value of time and get the total number of seconds. Now using a cute little for loop, we'll start from the total number of seconds and until we reach zero, we'll do a bunch of stuff like decrementing seconds and printing out some gorgeous cutouts. Yep. But then, we'll see if the number of seconds are giving zero when divided by 60. That will mean that a minute has passed or a minute needs a decrement of 1. Get it? Then we'll also set seconds to 59 if they reach 0 unless they'll be going to negative integers. We don't want to travel back in time. We're just a bunch of kids in the basement trying to make a stopwatch. Don't forget what we came here for. Now, I'm on Clang. If you're on Windows, you'll need to include this library that I mentioned earlier. I'll write here in a comment. Now I'll write system sleep 1. For Windows, it may be the same or it'll be timeout 1. Or you could just write sleep 1. What all of these mean is that the execution will stop for 1 second before moving on. I'll comment out the extras. Now we need a clean screen for every loop so I'll clear the terminal at every iteration. And of course, for Windows command prompt, it's CLS. Let's get out of here and clear the screen at the end. After a clear screen, we'll print a pretty message saying that our timer has ended after the entered seconds. With some blush and eyeliners. With an alert sound which you can do with a backslash A. Now let's compile and run the thing. Enter the seconds, 8. Minutes 0. Aha. Nailed it. Now if you enter seconds that are greater than 59, you won't be let gone. Anyway, let's enter minutes this time. 4 of them.
2,000 years later.
That's it, folks. Let's trot off now. Empty the basements. Subscribe to Code Might before you leave.